I, Comrade MC Onishi,
Chairman,
Federal Delegation in Hamufu, hereby nominate Comrade Onyebuchi Eze, Secretary, South East Zone, as a member of the Electoral Committee. Thank you.
Zaria.
and observe the COVID protocol, please, as you take your seats.
The next question. No, please.
From the and first, it can be there. By the time the electoral committee is inaugurated, they come here. I'll continue with the proceedings and they will take those seats.
Okay, come to this way, Zaria.
Zaria is here. Zaria is here.
Apoka,
sit there.
Show Shandari. Come here, come here. Chairman and Secretary. Sangama.
Do you have other delegates with you?
Yes. Okay.
Not just
here,
sir. Okay. Delegates.
Chair, sir, and delegates.
What's happening with this?
Billy, a fancy.
We don't expect Billy to be fully consistent because they are observers. So you can just admit the chair and say, no, Billy, when this is Billy, we can get it and can't say it's coming. They are all observers, just two delegates to observe and report back to their house.
When we so the next one. That will be here. No, this is so.
This place is
for the public. Advance it.
Advance it.
Advance it. Rousseau. Rousseau. Four. Busson, how many are you?
Busson, how many are you?
I mean,
we
are meeting you for here. The rest, yes, the rest. If you raise the rest of you, you move, you take four. Go sit here, sir. Busson, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. Obudu. Obudu. Gindiri, Gindiri, Koko. In repeating, the third row. You go, come on, or come down. How many?
Two.
Okay. You can be. Zuba. Believe me.
What's right
here? Just pass. Where is Mosuna? Okay. You can start from there. Just. Yes. Correct. Believe me. Believe me. Four. Okay. Believe me and sing. Go up again. This is for Panchi. Yes. Zuba. Yes.
Zuba.
So
go to the
okay. Not more than four. Ehabu. Ehabu. How many of you? And a book. Advan. Okay.
Come to this. This
is
happening. Who moves it? Aponga. Okini. Next one. No, together. One more. Aponga. You haven't been here. Hold those Cassettes. How many do this? Four. Cassettes. You have two. Take from there. This road. You have four days. Iguende.
This morning session for us to take two or three quick and critical decisions very quickly before we proceed to inaugurating the National Electoral Committee that you constituted yesterday. The GS, wherever you are, please find your way in here. Who should have taken two of these issues actually when we met before we proceeded into the discussions proper? You see, there's something that we don't always like to do, and that is pretend when we see certain developments, when we see certain misdemeanor, when we see things related to welfare and all that. That is why we're bringing in two or three issues before us so that we can quickly take decisions on them. Then the third one, those of you that were here during the summit, the principal work on the summit is about being done. And we actually had an appointment with the minister 2 Mondays ago, but the director, the DD, called me to tell me that the minister was not around, and that was why the meeting was postponed. They could call us to meet with him any moment from here. So that's why we hastened the printer towards getting the work done. So please, those of you that took on the panels, I need a list. I mean your lists. Those the panelists. Then delegates that were also at the sessions. I need those lists. Please. What I will pray that you assist me to is just come put down your name with the AGS. Just put down your name and tell him what you serve in. If you are on the panel of funding, for example, just say panel funding. Or your name, you say funding panel. No, Ogilema, funding panel. Or no, Ogilema, curriculum panel. No, Ogilema, governance participants. To distinguish, because panelists, were different from the participants. Those of you who were there, and then the panelists with the lead, the spokesman, and the chairman were on the high table at the Bureau Center. So we need those lists because we're giving him a holistic report. And the format is taken for you to be aware. We'll still send it to you. We'll call send copies to you. The format will take the format that the NUC adopted in their report of the retreats we had that I'm aware of. It's a comprehensive report. But we're hoping that with the help of God, moving forward, government may see the need to resort to that document in addressing certain policy issues with regards to those thematic areas that we handle. Thank you. That's the announcement. Then the third one will lead us to the inauguration of the electoral committee, because that's to do with election. The second one has to do with welfare. In my brief introductory, please, Baba Sanihu is not here. It's not just that he's away. Honestly, he's been battling. And the little way that we did, just as we've been doing to some of us, when our attention is drawn to any of our members that may be having issues, we give assistance. Yes, it's allowed to give assistance. Even you can give assistance to any member that runs into problems, serious problems, health challenges, whatever it is. His case actually started here in Abuja when we came for a physician assignment. And then we had to rush him to our hospital. They couldn't take care of him. We took him to another one. Before we chartered a car to take him, because he came by commercial vehicle and the state he was in. After the initial treatment, we had to charter a vehicle to take him there. Please note what I'm saying. To take him to Kano. And there's a prof who did us very well that kept him company. I just pray that God Almighty rewards him abundantly. So we were on an assignment when that prof volunteered and took him, a professor. He kept his company and he drove. We chartered, like I said, had to charter a car. That case is not over. On our way to Portistone, we had a stopover in Kano. We went and rode Kano. The state he was in is not good. He sent me a text just last week because he was supposed to have a surgery, but they couldn't use the laser on him because it had degenerated. And I will speak to a fault, you may say, or wish to say, I will go beyond my limits. I know my limits. And I do know that God has done just that. So what I need of you, in fact, the first thing that came to mind was Baba was a former president of this union, and he's from Kano here. from Kano here, please, my chairman, Dr. Saidu, please, when you get back, I know you are very close to Dr. Saidu, the provost. Please tell him. Because what I would have simply done was to walk straight to his office to tell him this. Sit, sir. If he's not aware, he should be aware that Baba is seriously sick. That's just what I want you to assist us to do. Please. I'm begging of us to give us the authority to do our best. The other time, Buhari, we heard of Buhari's sickness very lately. Shortly before his death, that's what I meant by lately. No, it's not just now. That was in 2019. If I'm not mistaken. October 2019. When we got to get the details of it, we were told that he was sick. What's the essence of going to give his family with the 500,000 that we gave him? If we could have easily given him that, that's not to say we would have said no. What I'm simply saying is, it is good we assist ourselves at least as much as possible. Not that somebody dies and then we are now saying when somebody dies, give him so. Before he died, more important. That's the real way. Like I said, Noc has done his best, but we're not yet there. He was referred again from one private hospital to another. That is a former deputy provost of FCE Kano. A former president, he said to be third. After the late Buhari Abadi, and I serve Akindele. I don't want to be saying about that because it will be giving the status I gave you as Makinde. So sir, I want to use my own language, Adai. Adai Sam was the second, he was the third. And they crisscrossed this country trying to bring this to where we are today. I'm happy Adai Abuja is here. When I saw him in the first time in Dubai, I just shook my head. I said, I wish I have the authority to constitute the electoral committee. But you guys did just that yesterday. And I was so happy. Some of the veterans that we've had, commendably so. You see, we're meeting again. If he hadn't done that, we wouldn't have been full of encomiums for him. Relationships don't just end the moment you saw yourselves. It lasts forever. For those who value relationship. Baba Saidu is in pains. We have a benchmark that we set ourselves at NOC. If somebody is sick, those that were kidnapped, then certain kind of sickness we categorized. I wouldn't tell you, it's not necessary. But we have gotten to the peak. And I don't want to go beyond that. So what I told them when we came, in fact, one year as his last began, I still think they were not sent to him. Because I need to take authority. Doesn't have a car. We shattered the car for him. Most of us travel down here, even not using official. We use our own personal cars. He does that. And some members of the NOC. We have to shatter a vehicle for him. Now the operation has not been done. They said he has to spend some time. And when he spoke with me, very faintly, we were there. Dama Kinde. Dr. Saga, who was with us again, and myself, and Bashir, and myself, who were en route, who were on our way to Potter School, en route camp. So please, my appeal to you is, and I want it to be so noted, whatever decision we take, do you allow us to try our best, or we leave it at the limit we set for ourselves, which we have exhausted? There's a certain limit we set for ourselves. We've done just that. That is what I want you people to help us do before we quickly take the other matter and then place we elaborate. Thank you, sir. Adaya, would you?
The Executive Council of the Union, congressmen and women present, those of us who joined this union much earlier, will know what these people mean to the union. Stanley Su, Akindele, and Buhari. Some few years ago, we had problem in Contagora. And I went to Mina to see Buhari to consult me. This is what they do for us. Consultants. And we pray they don't just go like that. Because experience is not gathered one day. My people have a saying that it is when a man is alive that you cry for him. Not when he's gone. Because when he's gone, whatever you do is just by the way. I believe that if anything, God forbid, if anything should happen to him today, this same union will run to the family and say, hey, madam, we are sorry. Whatever we could do or we would have done if he were no more, let us do it now that he's alive. He means much more to us alive than dead. So I want to suggest that even if your limits have been stretched, let us still outstretch that limit a little bit and see what we can do to save it. Salisu is a very, very, very good man. Very honest, if you know him well. And very accessible at any time, any day. And he laughs with everybody. Please, sir, if there's anything we can do to keep Salisu alive, let us do it now. Thank you.
Thank you so much, sir. We'll just take two more contributions, and then we'll take a decision on it. I'll take one more here, and I'll take... I'll take three more. And then which is from your place? You are the chairman, no, he's... He has spoken. I'll take Consul here, and I'll take Dr. Said there, and then Lana last. Come forward. No, whatever other thing you need, my chairman, you come tell me. Piero, give it to him. My chairman, come now.
The president and members of the NOC, from our president, my fellow colleagues, the leader here has spoken. One thing I will remember was Baba Salisu. He was the one that met Shehu Shagari College of Education to really insist after the state government has prescribed in 2000. Year 2000, when he assumed as president, the members of the college community approached him in state to ensure that he has seen the state government and was to be reinstated. And we have achieved a lot from there. And I know the former AGS, Dr. Sumaila, did a well done job when the first election after reinstating was made to that college. I know how that man contributed to the success of Wazo. And this is going to be and I would like to appeal to all of us here, just like what the president and the leader have said here, the only thing we can do for a fellow colleague is when he's alive. After he died, there's nothing we can do for him apart from prayer. But for now, physically to assist him, we are not saying that when it is time for him to go, we'll stop that. No, we will never. But at least, even his family will come to understand that this man has worked for these people, and we are seeing the dividends of what he has done. He's not going to take this time. This is the same person that traveled from Sokoto to Maiduguri, from Lagos to Port Harcourt, from Maiduguri to Port Harcourt, from Sokoto to Lagos. And I think he deserves something. So I'm appealing to the North Officers, please, and the entire House and the leader. There was a period whereby if we are struggling, we say that we move out of the cycle. We go ahead to move south. Even if you are stretched, you have reached your limit. With this kind of situation and the very pressing question, there is the need for us to agree here. They should move out to do everything the very possible to assist and take this life. Thank you very much.
Mr. President, other members of the High Table, distinguished colleagues, good morning everyone. I simply want to expatiate on what the President has said on the petition for our side. We are all from Canada. Like he said, he came here and he developed a unitary program and not did what they did and they were taken to Canada. Why in Canada? We took him to a private hospital. Lots of tests were conducted and the results indicated that he needed to be needed to undergo a surgical operation. So we contacted a private hospital and they gave a very outrageous gift. So we have no option but to go to public medical facility. So they also did additional tests. And in the end, he was taken to the theater. For 3 hours, the doctors, tried all their best to accomplish the desired operation. But in the end, it was unsuccessful. They blame it on the condition of the facility they used, the machine they used, that it is not capable of, and they are taking such a complex operation. And because of the injections, because of the trial and the error made in the theater, Baba Simon's condition degenerated. And at that time, he was like unconscious. So he had to remain there for some time before we took him back home. And in the end, they said the only option is to go to that particular private hospital that from the beginning gave that outrageous number. And for him to survive, he has to undergo this operation. And for this operation to take place, we must produce this. So this is where we are now. I am appealing to my colleagues to please consider the appeal of the National President and save the life of one of our great leaders. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
The President of our great union, our leaders, former presidents, members of the NOC, distinguished comrades. I want to support everything already said by those who spoke earlier. But in addition, I want to make two remarks. Number one is that we are very proud of the leadership of this union because the angle the president came from is very impressive. I don't think anybody will have any problem if the president and our leaders have used their discretion to go beyond the limit, which of course was not set by us or the Constitution, or by themselves. But this is a show of accountability and responsible leadership, and that is commendable. And certainly, without trying to sound too religious, I want to suggest that before we close our discussion on this matter, we should raise prayers based on our two prominent faiths for this, our esteemed and distinguished foremost leader. And finally, I will say that I want to appeal that this SDC should empower the leadership of this union to commit available resources as much as it is required, without limit, as much as it is required, because we cannot do too much under this circumstance. We are talking about his life. And this life is precious to us, given the contributions he has made to our development. Thank you, sir.
Thank you for that, Mr. President. Sincerely,
I want to go in line with most of the same resolutions. I died at Abuja as a director of that school. We lost 8 colleagues this year. Some of them naturally, there are those who are in critical condition. We've contributed money to save lives. Those who die here, the family of our colleagues, we decide to contribute 500,000. So I want to suggest here, to whatever team you will actually give on our behalf, we have about 710 or so. So 71 colleges, they are responding. Who will give that with too much? I want to suggest from that offer, both
it's overwhelming that we should try whatever we can to assist him. The only angle that the chair Pentagora introduced is to also make you contribute. But you say that we should take that responsibility that you give up. If you want to fix a building, then you have to do your own. It's not forced. Charity is not forced. And charity is not, has no limit. And charity, again, the third one, charity is done according to your capacity. If you pick it, there may be some of you who could offer more than that. Who could offer more than that. If you don't also pay it, if you don't decide to bring it down, there will be some of you. There are some people here now. Their chapters are going there. Where will they get the money? So what we will do, I accept that with the modification. Please don't just allow us to limit ourselves. Whatever, even as individuals, wallahi, whatever you pay, in one hadith of the Prophet, you can get 2 million. The least you get is 10. There's no good thing that anybody does that goes all the way by Allah. It's only evil you do. Allah will forgive you, keep forgiving you. But Matthew is this to the right. Those of you Muslims know what I'm talking about. Allah will give you a long rope to pull. God doesn't need to start running like they run. That's why you can do your evil. Because if also can take you, you can just do like this. One man, one athlete, you can just make it break. That's the end of it. We can start chasing you and chasing you. That is how it is. There's no amount of guilt you do that Allah does. If however little, Allah rewards it. It's not an unjust God, no. And there are some amount that you will do, you don't even know the game, because until maybe after death. So it is very, very good to involve or indulge yourself in charity. So, having said this, whatever you can do, you have given us the permission and I want to appreciate it. Believe you me, deep inside me, I felt so happy hearing from you. I mean, having heard from as you are speaking, hearing from you. So whatever you can do, please don't think you have taken a decision, you limit it. Do on your own and God will pay you. I want to thank you. We will do whatever we can on your behalf. I will let you know. The second one, I'm sorry, the third one and the last one, which has to do with us, I have to stand up because it involves or concerns two people and they are close to me in a way. At least the two of them used to be close to me. I don't know now that they are looking for elections. Maybe they may not be close because they have. I spoke with Azari Chairman last night. I got information. You know, I've been full of, I've been fuming. Let me use fuming about election. The integrity that should go with it. The love that should go with it. Now we love ourselves. This is our union. It's just there. And all that. Somebody drew my attention to one issue that I hammered on. And quickly, I called. Where's Bella? Why would you guys not give me details of these matters? I didn't call the former chairman of Azari, who had decided to distance himself from us. I called his chairman. The second person is my brother, a friend, and somebody I just naturally like, Lana. I'm not campaigning, please. Lana, you guys know that I'm not giving Lana here. I didn't call him. I didn't call him too. We just met ourselves this morning. But Ogabakine, I told you, Ali, I told Ogabakine, that's how I do my work. When it is a public matter, relationships are set aside. Positions of authority
that anybody may be wealthy and set aside. Look at what those of you must look at what Umar did. In that arbitration between him and them, and they were trying to recognize him, what he said, no, don't look at my position. Already you are compromised, my leader. I don't want to look at my position. Some of you may not know that I'm somebody that was engaged, same running. Some have already spoken about him and said, they are doing well. Do you know what I did? What was the staff audit? You told me that you are aware in the Janiki. I said this to you before, but understand, how do you know my principle? Whatever you make of me, one life, I don't care. Because you don't make my life. You have nothing to do about my life. GS told me they were in Ijaniki to conduct audit on Ijaniki and where?
Elisha.
No, not Elisha. Anekwe. I said, call him now. This guy said he won't contest Elisha. Call him. Let us. That I like you does not mean I will not tell you what we're supposed to tell. That your close to us does not mean we not tell you one lie. I, no believer will never quit. I told you, those of you in Zuba, that I met it to you. Even my wife, I will come and answer. Because of the day of judgment, you will account. And I'll be accountable. To look on the wrong in you, to look on the school, and to write anything. You'll be asked, all of us say we're leaders, and God will ask you how you have taken the crop. Because of you, come and have it at your face. You can say something and overlook it. There are things you can say, and honestly, I'm over that. I will overlook this one, the other one. I mean, your own personal reaction now on what we are doing. Why? There are ways you can even make observations. This, my friend, Konagura, is a brother and a friend and a colleague in this, on the same profession. They even petitioned me. Oh, God, when you even start, I think your name is still there. But you don't stop me from doing the business, you know what? No, I'm not lying. Wallahi, I'm not lying. That petition, I don't know where it's in the file. But we have to do business of union. And I attended to it because they were objective. They didn't give my attention to some articles. You know what? Okay, some of this is central to zero, and what did they say? They said I did the zero in North Central. What is the material? They said I was playing them. They gave me like order. I said, how can you order me around when I'm preparing for SDC? You gave me 24 hours to be in Kotagora. The other time I came, one village, all of them were carrying guns. Before now, Tegina on the way. Before Tegina, they gave me back. Before Tegina, there was one community that was raised up by bandits. They drove Dr. Ahead. You call it Zungeru. A village in Zungeru, a particular village was sent back in there, running down, acting. Just close to Zungeru, you pass Zungeru, you are acting together. That was where the governor was. That was the matter that the governor took to Mr. President. See, it is after this one that those guys that were carrying on that day, they were out. So this guy, my chairman here, won't give me 24 hours to start coming. Number one, I'm not prepared myself with prayers. Number two, no policemen, no security. You know that letter on Thursday last week, and secretary called me. I just laughed. You know the thing I come on Saturday, meanwhile, Saturday was doing 12. I got them like a night of Thursday. I'm not going back to God. They had that meeting, and that meeting they said, crucify this guy. They brought it, they brought it. Well, you see, that is it. That is job. We took it all. We discussed it. I said, there's no sign against me. That is how business of collecting is done. We don't personalize it. And we are not targeting people. We're just looking at the situation. That's our plan. So how can we start going to Kutagora now without this Wahala? I saw Kutagora like a chairman in fairness to me and yourself. Why did I tell you when I came? I said, I saw everybody carry guns. Boko Haram had immediately that they put that particular village. They did what they did. These people discovered that one traditional head collaborated. So they prepared themselves because we asked the guy that we checked the car, the guy that we brought on, we they prepared themselves. Do you know that even young people as young as 12 years, they were carrying guns. German, what did I say? I said, if I knew, I wouldn't, because I slipped the Zuma meeting there. I said, I wouldn't have scheduled that meeting. I don't like putting people's lives into risk. This meeting would have been, maybe this one would have been coming, or the NDC, because of the security situation. You know, those, we drove, the other time, Dr. Saka and I drove, we went to come. He said, I said, what? He said, he's been looking at, I've been watching you. You know, I was driving. He said, what they are hearing down there? Believe me, he said, he felt that that one was not traversable. I said, oh, it's all going on. Have you lied against you? He said, this is it. So if you don't witness something, you will not. It's one of the people that all the wrong eyes. That's why I don't subject people to wahala. It's not that I tell them, no, we're lying, whatever we are doing. I've been saying it, and I'm saying it again. It's just how this funeral will move. There are some things that affect my person. But I just must do it. I want to get a decision of myself. Look, okay, maybe you presided. I give this man a small chance. You know, he's been presiding for some time now, you have observed. He was not only presiding national meeting, he was also presiding non-committee. There was one decision I took, they overturned it. I lied. One serious decision. That even if you did implement this, that government will not receive this decision. This guy came and don't give a 360. You are lying. I don't say, okay. This guy came, he uses a phone. I said, you should look at you now. I respect your decision. I don't cool myself. That is just us. And that is me. Please. Chairman Elisha is a good guy. He's my guy, the kind of people I like to work with. No, I'm not campaigning. No, let me. No, I'm going somewhere. That has not stopped me. And I'm also urging us to look at this. These are things that God Himself likes. We cannot all be behave the same way. And if there's a dissenting voice, if there's any opposition to whatever I'm doing, honestly, I review myself. How can I expect to be accepted by everybody when prophets of God were not accepted? You can't. If everybody is dreaming that everybody will accept him, no. So that's why I apply myself to that. That's the solace I have. But if I like you, I won't allow you to influence anything. When I got that of his own, like I said, I didn't call him as close or as much as. I didn't call you. Did I ever call you about the auntie today? And I said, how can it be? He was part of the review committee and all that. So, Ogbakunde knows. I didn't ask. This one yesterday, when my attention was drawn to it, I called Bella. It's not here. I said, what? I had this. He said, yes. Now, what did you do? He said, they even at the zonal level, they took the matter up. I said, okay, what is this? What do you do? They said they decided to ask the contestant. He said, no. What is it? What is the chairman you should relate with now? He's a former chairman, he's the ex officio. What did the chairman said? I said, let me go hear from him. I picked my phone. Chairman told me that yes. The way I'll present it is that it's yes and no. The fact is, the immediate past chairman, like I said before, he started to distance himself. It's our link. We have three links to the minister. Three. Official. Unofficial. The unofficial is twofold. It's one of the unofficial is the most effective of the unofficial. We have two links, official and unofficial. The unofficial one of the two, because of the personal relationship. But the other one is office and is also personal. But on his own, even if he didn't, what is that? What? You said what? No, we can't come with that. If I need to call, I'll call you. So,
That is the relationship he has with us. If you are understanding him, we have emphasized this so much. Centrally, it was in one of those serious issues we tried in Aguada. I don't expect that if anybody is hostile, you'll be there, and eventually, because it's never told me, yes or no, yes, that is, yes, it's hostile, know that he has written. And that is not a matter of writing. Because I have said it here before you, that our engagement with MTS heads has given us a lot of concern for us to be sufficiently worried. I will not allow any policy matter, our constitution, to give, to create any lacuna that will affect the policy of government. I know you guys can bear me witness. Lana, the Southwest, they met. Baba Makinde himself took that and they did what they did, carrying out their investigation. That is not my business. They will be doing their own when electoral committee comes into play. The area I'm going is, that's another case there. The chairman told me on phone, well, I can't be giving details of what we discussed, no. And Azare has been also as dutiful as a chapter. That is where we are, and I want the electoral committee to take administrative note of that. Two, I want this house. We told you, I made it clear not to you yesterday. I made it clear not to you yesterday that we shall be conducting forensic audit. Two audits are waiting us. We'll do an audit after this. Because I've just even seen that this matter are pulling that up now. We'll do another audit. That is, if eventually what is not expected happens. Number one, should there be a situation where, having looked at their papers, that there will be two of them coming up with, should there be a situation where they are cleared, the NOC should be ready to conduct a verification. The verification, like I said, we were in talks with ICPC. I will tell them we will collaborate with you. We were in touch with TEDFOR, and we told them we are not party to all that's been happening. Like I told you yesterday or before, all of the folks that have maybe left around is a blighted image. I'm not saying now. You obtain a sponsorship, you abandon it, and you have paper. It's an indictment on your person. And the collective image of the organization or the family you represent, we will not allow that to happen to us. If you have claimed them, take one is there. See to what extent they have paid, if they have withdrawn their services or their studentship. By the time it's handed over to NOC, NOC will take it up from there. The only time we are discussing, my chairman, what we are discussing about what is from some of our colleagues have before ICPC today. Or similar matter. Let me end it there. I don't want to take your time. I need to inaugurate you and get going somewhere. What I now want is this. I want a decision from you that after this election, just a decision, just as we resolve the issue of my personal, just I leave my tower, my small tower, one I keep in the car. Sorry, please. Please, I want this special in this Congress. Because I would, with the registry of trade union representatives as witness, and God as my witness too, that I've tried my best to be fair to everybody. When I decided to bring the matter as a fighter, I didn't know that all this were happening. The ones I got to know were that of the VP. In fact, the first one was ATS. I didn't know your matter. ATS is doing his PhD. In fact, he's done with his PhD. He's at the thesis level where Nasarawa, we told him. See, this is not about you, it's about the union. I never knew my vice president is doing his PhD when he left the UK. He didn't even tell me. He is in AB, he never would tell me that to have told to anyone. Bella is in ATBU.
said I was very curious about it. Very curious, because you cannot be surrounding me like this. I knew that from India because he told me. But you guys didn't tell me anything. And Lord, I was shouting, telling you guys, Abby, that your course, go and do your course. And I'm not getting more vision, I'm not bringing it forward. I'm not that type of person. We need to be fair to everyone. I will tell them, bury your ambition. Where's Howard? Howard! You know, I won't tell them, but because me, I'll bring it here. That was exactly what we did. This gentleman eventually just helped me with you, this aspiration. Tell her the same thing. Do you think I'll close my eyes to this one? Chairman Nazareth. And Madam. Correct. I would not. Because God, judgment is a judgment coming. Judgment days that even if you try to overlook, as Nigeria is overlooking practically everything today. But look at where we are. In a kind of jagajaga state. Please, that is just it. So I am appealing to you to empower NEC, National Executive Council. Because National Executive Council is a council for chairmen and secretaries. So that in the event that after the election, because we also provide that after the election, any officer that has been found not to have been qualified. Because the constitution actually envisaged the possibility of falsification. Yes. There's a clause there that says even after election, if anybody is found to have lied, it will be taken off. That is how it is. So that at the end of the day, we don't have to call all of you back here. We don't have to say STC, we are reconvening to conduct by election. So the appeal is, please, give the NEC the authority to reconvene if there is a possibility of by election after this ongoing process. That is why I brought it here. So that at the end of the day, if there is no cause for alarm, after this screening and election, no one will think about it. They can just go. But if eventually there is cause to have the assistance, so that NEC, this one costs lots of money, bringing everybody here. No doubt about it. So that NEC wouldn't have to, thank you, sir. NEC wouldn't have to reconvene to save cost and for effective mobilization of all. That is just the decision I want from us. The Electoral Committee will handle the other matter of going into the details of it. I want to thank all of you so far, and I want to thank you particularly that you are so meticulous to have come up with the 5-man panel of people of integrity that I'm seeing here. And I want to also appreciate the fact that even though they are not here presented, the brief I had was to the fact that the South big knob is quite incidental. That's the way it has been designed by God to go. So they will represent you well. They were very dispassionate in handling of the affairs. So I want to thank you so much. And I want to call the members of that committee to please come forward for your inauguration. Members of the National Electoral Committee, come forward for inauguration. There's not much of a ceremony that we do as they do at the state house or at government houses. So, trusting in God, believing in you, as evident in the services you have, some of you have rendered while in the service of leadership, and some of you are still rendering even in your various institutions. We vest a lot of confidence in you, and that is why we have nominated you. And it is God's dream. We only actualize it. We only choose in the hands of God. We are believing that you keep God in your view as you are hereby constituted as members of the National Election Committee
of the Colleges of Education Academic Staff Union. Here with me that I'll hand over to Mr. Chairman to is the instrument of authority. In this, you have the Constitution of the Union.
You have
five copies of it.
Okay. We have,
of course, three forms. I mean, first, guidelines are drawn from the Constitution that we use. And then we have forms there that are appropriate to the discharge, or appropriate and relevant for you, for the effective discharge of your functions, for you to peruse. You can modify those forms should you wish, but the guidelines are there as strictly provided by the Constitution and interpreted by us. As we take this responsibility, we pray, we hope and pray that God assists you in the discharge, in the dispassionate discharge of this onerous responsibility. So congratulations. 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 Yeah. Congratulations. Miss, will you come up, please?
Wait, who said no? No, we empower you.
My chairman, please come forward.
Okay.
My president, honorable officers, your president, my distinguished colleagues, haven't listened to the presentation of the president on this issue. I wish to support and suggest that NEC be empowered. Okay. In view of the presentation of Mr. President on the fact that in case an aspirant or an elected officer is found wanting at the end of the election, NEC should be empowered. I have a move that NEC should be empowered to take other further necessary actions, either in the form of a by-election or whatever, to rectify the anomaly.
Okay. I, the chairman of ACOCA, hereby support the motion that in case of any eventuality that will lead to disqualification of any candidate that might have contested in this election, let the power to carry out the by-election and do the
needful.
Thank
you. Please let me count your motion.
Hi. It should be so noted. Thank you so very much. Sir.
As you already knew, that this committee has as its members men with wealth of experience in conducting elections, and that with the confidence reposed on this committee, we promise you that we are not going to do anything that will jeopardize that confidence, that we are not going to do anything that will bring this noble union to disrepute. We are going to follow the election guidelines strictly in accordance with the provisions of our Constitution, and we will come out with a result that all of us are going to be proud of. Meanwhile, there is something I want to seek clarification from you. The election guideline says that we should conduct election today and tomorrow. And since yesterday evening, I've been hearing some little underground bickering here and there that we are beginning to overstay. Do you give us the permission to conduct this election today?
Yes. Yes.
So, the secretary will come forward now to read out to you the election guidelines and like what? So that you give us a little time to tidy up. We'll be convened by 2 o'clock. Is that all right with us? Or is 2 o'clock too far?
It's too far.
It's quite for it. It's quarter to two.
What?
Quarter to two has already.
You convert by one.
By one. Okay, can we convene by you?
One.
Please, give us the time so that we don't disappoint you. Please. So we'll come up with everything that is required for the lecture. So please, we reconvene by 2. And when we say exactly 2, please, exactly 2, let every delegate be here. Do we agree with that?
Yes, sir.
We are going to present this thing to you one by one. The secretary will do that now, and we'll give copies of the timetable to zonal coordinators who will, in their wisdom, make copies available to their chapter chairman if they so wish. There's one other thing that happened. We were thinking of concluding all the elections today, but we were made to understand by the secretariat that some people have been invited to come and oversee the conduct of the election tomorrow in the morning. So we are going to do all other preliminaries and do zonal election today. Then in the morning tomorrow, we take on the manifesto presentation by the secretaries, aspirants to the office of the secretaryship, and those of the presidency. We finish with that, we screen them immediately, and we go into the election. It will not take us time. If God be with us by 2, we would have been done. So that those that are not too far away can take their leave, and those that are far, please, because of the exigencies of our time now, I would not advise you to travel late in the night because our roads are not safe. So the secretary will present the document to you and will make copies available to your zonal coordinators. Thank you very much.
I have 2 documents. I have the election timetable and the guideline. On our program, election timetable, release of election guideline and timetable at 2 o'clock. And I want to go through the guideline that we are going to use for the election. The first part of the guideline affects candidates, and the second part affects the institution. Because the institutions are the ones that will vote. The institution constitutes our voters list. Guideline for candidates. Interpretation of the criteria for eligibility of chapters and individuals provided for the union's constitution are further enunciated in the underlisted conditions and guidelines. For the avoidance of doubt, chapters and individuals must meet the following conditions to be qualified to run for any national election. For candidates, 1, pursuant to Article 13, for those of us that have the Constitution, if you check Article 13 from page 33 to 36, you will see the guideline provided for eligibility for a candidate to contest for a national election. Any candidate who has left school must prove beyond reasonable doubt that he or she has completed the program of studies enrolled for. To prove that the candidate must provide the following. 1, the original copy of academic certificates. 2, letter of deferment from the institution clearly specifying the duration of deferment. However, the convener shall not apply to those on telephone sponsorship. 3, letter of resumption to work or completed resumption from his or her college. 4, statement of result or second award. All that work must be accompanied with letter clearly written and forwarded to the chairman of the electoral committee. 4, any
individual who has abandoned his study after he has been granted certain fellowship is not eligible to run for any office for us. And finally, any individual thought to have been engaged in anti-union activities, financial frauds in the union or larger society, or an ex-convict is going to be disqualified. That's for the candidates. Therefore, the institutions, that's the voters list, what qualifies an institution to vote, will be voted for. One, chapters that have neither fulfilled their financial obligations nor on payment of such obligations to the national secretary shall not participate in the election. For the avoidance of doubt, they can neither present candidates for the election nor be allowed to vote during the election. Two, chapters from 3 points below are not qualified to vote or present candidates to be voted into any office of COEASU, giving their visible membership status. Three, any chapter that has not written to clarify its status in response to the summary assessment of chapters as contained in the chapter status chart shall not have its complaint effected at all. Four, any chapter whose written complaint and or clarification is not found to be possible shall not have its status reviewed. Five, any chapter which did not remediate its deficiency in the obligation as stated on the chapter status chart before the election shall not be qualified to vote or present candidate to be voted in office. Six, any fake declaration by either a chapter or candidate shall be appropriately sanctioned, which include automatic forfeiture of such office and other sanctions as provided for in the new constitution as soon as it is discovered. Finally, for a chapter or candidate to vote or be voted for, the fine that may have been imposed on such a chapter that did not partake in 2018 national strike must have been paid. Failure of which the representative of such a defaulting chapter shall have to sign an undertaking to pay the said fine within 3 months after commitment or failed appropriate sanction or sanctions. That's the guideline for candidates and chapters. The timetable for election. Release of guidance and timetable, that's what I've just read. Two, sale of election nomination forms, which will commence as from 12:15 in the next 5 minutes. President, 40,000. General Secretary, 35,000. Vice President, that's zonal officer, 30,000. All fees are non-refundable. Three, return of all completed forms between 2:40 and 3 p.m. All completed return forms must be submitted today before 3 p.m. Five, release of names, four, screening of candidates between 3 to 4 p.m. Screening of successful candidates. Five, release of names of successful candidates between 4 to 4:15 p.m. today. Six, presentation of zonal manifestos by the six contestants from the six zones between 4:20 to 5 p.m. today. Seven, zonal elections between 5 to 6 p.m. today. Eight, release of zonal election results between 6:15 and 6:30 today. 9. Collection of election petition, if any, from 6:30 p.m. to 8 p.m. today. That's day 1. Day 2, tomorrow. 1. Presentation of manifestos by elected zonal officers. All elected zonal officers that will aspire for portfolio will have to present their manifestos tomorrow by 10 o'clock. 2. Manifestos presentation by General Secretary. 3. Manifestos presentation by presidential contestants. 4. General elections. 5. Release of results. And 6. Collection of petitions, if any, which will be done until 2:30 at 3 p.m. tomorrow. Thank you.
My colleague, numbering
10. 10 in number, all the nomination
that were collected. And
from the information we have from our finance house, these are the chapters that are eligible to vote and be voted for, and from whom we have collected nomination forms. Beginning from the North Central, we have Bansin, Akwanga,
from North Central, we have Bansin, Pantagora, Okene, Zuba, and Zuba, five all together. From North East, from North East, we have Kobe, Otisko, Yola, Andali, and Pong. Five altogether. Then from North West, we have Kano, Bichi, Kefuna, Zaria, Sokoto, and Busa. Six on number. Then from the South East, we have Eha Amufa, Alban, and Muzi. Three altogether. Then from South South, we have Azaba, Obudu, Omoku, Agu, and Akampa. That's five altogether. And finally, South West, we have Ondo, Abeokuta, Akoka, Oyo Special, Alayandi, and Ileza. Six. So if we put up all together, we have 30. 30 all together. 30 centers are going to vote. Thank you.
So you have had the names of the chapters that are eligible to vote and be voted for. We are going to proceed by calling the nominees from these zones to come for screening. And we are going to do the screening here. So we will start from the bottom up. We call on the zonal nominee for the Southwest Zone. The nominee for the Southwest Zone. Yes, sir. Emmanuel Lama Oluwaseun.
Lama Emmanuel Oluwaseun.
So what we have is what we are working on. You can see. I have a photocopy of his results. So you collect it. So what available for his own beliefs. So, for the benefit of that, I will bring out the names. Dr. Owesini A, VP South South, Dr. Shehu Jamaka, VP Northwest, Lana Emmanuel Olusegun, VP Southwest, Noah Elani, VP North Central, Mohamed Bello Umar, VP Northeast, and Dr. Abu Ikechukwusi, VP Southeast. These are the six candidates that have been successfully cleared on test for the post of the Vice President. President, and all of them are going on the post, one per zone. Next is Dr. Ahmed Bada, General Secretary. He's also going on the post here at the screen. For the President, three candidates have been cleared to contest. They are as follows. One, Dr. Sunday A. I don't know, I'm not able to pronounce the name. Abolo, President. Two, Dr. Smart Olu Beko. And Olayinji Kale A. The three aspirants will be contesting for President. By this announcement now, we have released the names of the qualified and cleared candidates to contest. The next part we'll go to now is presentation of manifestos by the vice presidents, the six zona vice presidents. They'll present their manifestos and then they will be, their election will be done now before close of the day. For the six zona districts. Then tomorrow, there will be election again then for their portfolios. They'll present their manifesto and they'll be, now they have to be elected by their zones. Please, we were giving another information which was not earlier given in our guideline. The ballot paper you are going to get is yes and yes or
no.
If the no takes over the yes, that means the zone will have to present another candidate. Is the language clear?
Yes.
Members of the zone, for instance, will have a paper that was earlier read for you. Let me say the first one, North Central. There are five schools in the North Central that are qualified to vote. If the five schools, probably five schools, four, five collective centers, five collective voters low, that means the candidate has been rejected. So the North Central will have to present another candidate. For the purpose of convenience and ease, since there is no contest, please, we are going to use only one box. And we will call zone by zone. We'll give you your ballot paper, we vote to the zone, we finish, we call the next zone like that, and we finish with the sixth zone. But before then, there will be a manifesto's presentation by the zonal vice president. And each of them will be required to speak to us for just 5 minutes. 3 minutes? Yeah. 3 minutes. Agent. Okay, so despite the fact that there is no election, sorry sir, the chairman said for us to prove our transparency free and fair so that we will not say there are no more than yes. This contestant should please bring his agent so that you will see the no and more than yes. We will not say to us that have done that. So this contestant, after the manifesto's presentation, we will go into the election. Now we start with the presentation of manifestos before the election. How do you want to start? The way we do the screen, we start from the bottom. Southwest. South. Where is he? It's not around. If it's not close by, we can say South South. South South. It's not around also. Okay, South South. What is it?
What do you think in?
Just 3 minutes. Your time starts now.
Distinguished comrades, my name is Martin Chandler.
I lecture at Oshofe College of Education in Asia. I present myself to serve this great union as National Vice President, Southwest Zone, and the Zonal Coordinator of Southwest. And I aspire to contribute my quota to the team as National Secretariat Affairs Officer. I teach in the Department of Christian Religious Studies in the School of Arts and Social Sciences in my college. I am a senior lecturer at my grant. I hold a first class Bachelor of Theology degree from UMC Theological College in Munich, in application to the University of Ibadan, and I hold a Master's of Arts degree in Religious Studies from Ekiti State University. By the grace of God, I have served this union as chapter secretary in my college from 2013 to 2017. I was elected unopposed as chairman of my chapter from 2017 till 2021. And I am also privileged to be serving my zone as the zonal secretary from 2017 till date. I have attended many national meetings, and this privilege has exposed me to the business of the union, and I am highly charged and inspired by the examples of selfless leadership shown by our great leaders of this union, from our former president to the current members of the National Officers Council. I feel I have something to contribute in consolidating on the achievements of the outgoing National Officers Council in moving our great union COEASU forward. If elected as vice president and coordinator of my zone, I will bring to the table my experience as the lead negotiator for polytechnic and college for education in Osun State to see how we can review our strategies towards making the impact of the union felt in state colleges of education. I implore you to give me your mandate, and I promise not to disappoint you. Thank you very much.
As the lecturer is going to be very critical, at least he has got the time to find the appeal room before he's 10 minutes. Thank you. We hope the other presenters will do the same thing. Next is the VP and coordinator from South South.
My name is Dr. Wesana Abukabobe. I'm a principal lecturer of the Department of Accounting Education, Federal College of Education, Technical Law. I feel I have something to offer in this great union. I have an HND in accounting education. I have a PhD in health accountancy. I have a master's in business administration. I possess a PhD in international business from the famous business school, International Business School of Paris. I'm also privileged to have studied doing business in University of Cape Town, South Africa Business School. I'm also privileged to have studied doing business at the University of St. John's, United States of America. I'm privileged to have studied doing business in India at the Hamilton Business School, New Delhi, India. With the wealth of experience I have used in my chapter, I have been able to establish cooperative society, COEASU cooperative society. With the same wealth of experience, I was able to establish the COEASU cooperative store. With the same wealth of experience, I've been able to establish the COEASU transport service. With the wealth of experience, I set up a committee for the establishment of agro business and fish farm. Also, I have decided to constitute the committee for COEASU NOC. I also feel that the national do not need to depend on check-up dues monthly. So if and when I'm elected, I will propose to the NOC for an establishment of a secondary cooperative society, and also encourage the zone to have a primary cooperative society. I'm also going to establish businesses in each of the six geographical zones based on the peculiarities of the various zones. I believe that with these of my wealth of experience and my area of competence, I am qualified to be elected as investment officer. Thank you.
Vice President has come from Southeast.
BSc in computer science.
I was a former chairman between 2011 to 2014. Considering the transparency, accountability of my stewardship as the chairman, immediately after my return from PhD studies, my Congress decided to re-elect me in 2019 to serve to be as their chairman. During the period under review, we have redefined COEASU in Federal College of Education Technical Research. We use teamwork among our colleagues, and we achieve a lot of successes. While I'm contesting for Vice President, Zonal Coordinator Northwestern, if elected, I will bring to the zone and to the center spirit of teamwork, hard working, transparency, and accountability. Despite our meager resources, COEASU FCT will suffer under my watch. Have fulfilled all the financial obligations. We are among the first chapters to implement 2% deduction before the APC implementation. I'm presenting myself before you, if elected, as the Zonal Coordinator and Vice President in the Northwest Zone, who will improve in the communication among our chapters. I promise to bring on board chapters that are having some issues. Thank you so much.
The VP presidential aspirant for the notice will be found to present your manifestos. Not also.
Chairman in my chapter, and then
I want to assure you, if you are giving me your mandate, if you are giving me your trust, certainly we'll do our best to transform our union. I have, during my time, I built, using the mega trust of my union and outsourced around outside, built a secretary of work, 17 million. In the morning, when the issue of Babasar was mentioned, I then touched. Because in my institution, we mobilized ourselves, our members, including the non-academics, into contributing 2% independent of the COEASU. And that came back to another scheme, our pair scheme. Every month we realized millions of members that we're giving to some of our patient members into agents. If Papa Salavu happens to be in my chapter, we can spend $3-4 million for the sake of this.
And lastly, but not least, the Vice President, aspirant from the North Central. Not in the Central, I'm spoiling my head, right? So, what's the matter with you?
The Chairman, Electoral Committee. Honorable members of the committee, my distinguished delegates, good evening. My name is Comrade Noah Adamu, vying for the office of the Vice President of COEASU, representing the North Central Stroke Middle Belt Zone. I hold a bachelor degree in political science by the grace of God, and just recently completed a master's degree program and is awaiting certification in political economy. My experience in unionism spans over a period of 25 years, beginning from my secondary school days. I have sat in this union in the capacity of chapter secretary between 2013 and 2017. Having performed excellently well, my Congress found me worthy to be once again as the chairman of the chapter. Subsequently, I was elected chapter chairman in 2017, the position hold till date. Today, I am presenting myself before these distinguished delegates to vie for the position of Vice President. As I present myself today, I want to assure all distinguished delegates that I have a very good understanding of the onerous and strategic responsibilities attached to the office of the Vice President. In giving the mandate, I do know that my responsibilities include the fact that as a member of the National Officers Council, I will participate actively in policy formulation and implementation, as well as in decision making. In that area, I can assure delegates that I will ensure effective representation of my zone. By way of experience,
all the names of those that have been accredited, and they will come to vote.
Thank you.
Ondo, Comfort.
Southwest.
Ondo, Comfort. Ondo, Comfort. Ondo, Comfort. Abeokuta. Where is Abeokuta? Stadium. Abeokuta. Abeokuta. They are not voting. Amen. Hungary.
Just one boy. 1, 2, so we look at it, 1 year, 2 years, 3 years, and 4 years. So we have 4 years at one point. From that one, you
Absent.
That's
for the zonal
election.
We have come to the end of
the election.
The vice president, zonal vice president.
Yeah. Vice president of zonal coordination.
I will start from
where?
Southwest. Those that want to go can go. I know.
We can offer him back to your wife as we live here now.
For your wife.
So that their minds can be at rest. Thank you.
Having wife. Not wife.
Those that are keeping concubines, don't call them.
No, wife. What is wife?
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.